Today, we've got something exciting to show you. I know you all been waiting for it. You probably already know what it is because I'm standing in front of it. But here we go. We have seats mounted in the vehicle. And not just sitting in here, they're actually mounted into the floor pan, bolted down. I've got 3 of the 4 bolts in each one of the seats right now. So let's take a little closer look and we'll kind of talk about what we're doing and what we're going to cover in today's episode. If you watched our bonus episode, we talked about having 2 different seats to choose from. I've got a 2015 set and a 2007 set. Don't ask me why I have 2 sets. I just kind of collected them along the way. But so this one is a 2007. The driver's side right now is a 2015. One of the factors that was going to influence my decision was the height of the seat. They're practically the same across the cushion. It's a little bit, probably a third of a headrest height difference in the height of the seat back. So the 2015 seats are a little taller. They're going to give, you can tell by the depths of the bolsters here, just visually, the newer seats have a much deeper bolster too. So it's going to hold corners a little bit better. The fabric is actually a little more grippy. It's more of a tweed pattern to the fabric, even in the surrounds. Another big difference is the outsides of the seats on the older sets are gray. On the new seats, they're black. So since I have kind of a blackish gray carpet, I could kind of go either way with that. One of the other things that's going to influence my decision is I bought a set of door panels from a guy that makes them on Facebook. Bought them about 1.5 years ago. I haven't even taken them out of the packaging yet. Life got in the way. I put them in storage. I don't even know what they look like other than a picture he sent me online. So we're going to unpackage those here in a couple minutes. And we're going to just loosely put them in the car, probably with a little piece of blue tape or something just to hold them up, just so we can kind of see. We'll look through this way, I'll put it on the driver's side, and we'll kind of see how it looks with the door panel. See if the newer seats are going to work with a little bit older fabric. I have an idea that it could, but I'm not quite sure. So that's going to be our episode today, is we're just going to kind of do some experimenting and look and see. And my helper just showed up. Come on, girl. Oh, come on. Good girl. And a helper, coach shop dog, showed up today to kind of give us a hand, so she'll be taking part in the fun. And that'll be it for today. So let's get these door panels unpackaged, and then we'll set one in the car, and then we'll talk a little bit more about the differences in the seats that I have, and we'll go from there. So you guys thought I was kidding when I said I haven't unpackaged these in about 1.5 years. Let's see if I have a shipping date on here. Let me take a look and see. Don't see. There's a shipping date, but I can't read it on there. May 2nd, 2016. So right now it's March 2017. So, okay, so not 1.5 years, but we're getting on about 1 year that I've had these. And I haven't done anything with them. They've just been literally sitting in a box. So let's get them out and take a look at them. And if you like them and you're interested in a set, I didn't get a discount on these. This was well before my YouTube days. There's no kickbacks or ads or reciprocating deals. I don't get anything from this guy. But it's SLOVWORKS on Facebook. Guy's name is Omar Pena, and I know there have been a lot of people that have ordered stuff from him. He's been pretty satisfied with his product, so hopefully we're no exception here. Thank you. Ooh, those are pretty cool looking. I can tell just from opening the package, they look pretty good. So what I ordered was a set of door panels in the original style with the ribbed fabric with the diagonal pleats for the original style door panels on the top, and then GTI fabric on the bottom. And they look like they're in pretty good shape. I was a little concerned because the box looked like it flexed a little bit in the center, but really, I don't see any issue with packaging. Looks like you did a good job, Omar. Oh man, these look pretty nice. Yes, I'm keeping them at angle so you can't see them until I get them out of the packaging. That way it's really like Christmas. Concern is that how long this tape's been on here. Will the tape come? There's going to be a little bit of residue on there, but we can clean that up with some adhesive remover. Oh, now you guys are getting a little peek here. And I'll tell you what, those are pretty. You can see there's a little bit of residue from the tape here, but I'm not worried about that. But look at that. Nice GTI plaid. Got a cutout for the armrest, cutout for the door handle. And then we just have some plain black cards to go in the back. This is kind of this diagonal pattern was what they used on the cars originally. So looks like, you know, I did a pretty nice job of making these lines match up. And I actually have an original door panel that we can compare this to. I'm gonna go grab that, we'll set it next to it, and we can compare this, the new door panel by SLOVWORKS, to an original 75 door panel. Stand by. All right, so here we have an original 75 door panel, and one that's a reproduction. So you can see they are really close. If you're missing anything, you're going to miss one little stamped line down here at the bottom, which is not a big deal unless you're going to be a real stickler for details. But if you're going to run a back seat, it's going to be behind the back seat anyway. The seat cushion is going to come in front of it. So originally these things were cardboard. They're never designed to last 40 some years. So the fact that these have survived without anybody cutting holes in them or anything like that is pretty cool. I don't have a set of fronts for these. All I have is the backs, but you know, you pick up spare parts along the way just in case you need them. So this will be the passenger side. And then you can see here it looks real similar to the original style. Use some staples on the card, on the board, to keep keep the fabric down instead of glue. But it's already got holes punched for the armrest if you want it. And if you don't want to run the armrest, you don't have to. It's not punched all the way through. And then a hole for the window crank. So I'd say these are a pretty nice set of door panels for I don't know if he's a shop or a homemade guy, but I'd say it looked pretty good. So I'm gonna grab a little blue tape. We'll go back into the car and we'll set this up and take a look and see if we like how they look with them in the car. We might just run them with either set of seats. We'll see. Hi, are you here to help? Good. I'm gonna put you to work today. All right, back in the car. And I just loosely put those door panels on with a little bit of blue tape. I didn't want to like screw pads in or the little prongs to connect them in into the door panels because it'll be easier to store them without the little door panel pins on it. But you can see now that we have them in place, even with the newer seats, they still match pretty well. One of the contributing factors to that, I'll move this up to the seat there so you can see what's going on. So I think that since the seats are black, they actually match pretty well. The pattern isn't quite perfect of a match, but I think it looks pretty good. I think that I would run them with either set of seats and not feel too much shame about it. So I'm pretty happy with that. So the differences between the seats. The older seats are from a two-door. The newer seats are from a four-door. These have manual back tilt. The newer seats have electronic back tilt. So you're going to have to get power to them so that the seat back will tilt. They still slide manually. They still height adjust manually, but the back tilt is adjusted electronically. So something we have to get power to the seat for, not a big deal, just another step that we have to do. Running the older seats will definitely give us a little bit easier access to the back seat. But honestly, how many times am I going to have someone in the back seat of this car? The back seat is going to be there for decoration, and the rare chance where I need to put four people into this car for some crazy reason. The most I ever see in here is two, maybe a third riding along just for the fun of it. But in my opinion, it wouldn't be a complete interior without the back seat. And I can always make him climb through the hatch if I really want to. Now that she is back from completing her other task, which involved going outside and I'm sure chasing something, which she didn't bring as an offering, which was good. So I think based on what we've got here, the fact that the door panels are not a perfect match, but a close enough match for the newer seats. And I do like the newer seats. I like some of the features. I like the under seat tray, which you can get for the older seats, but I already have it. I can sell these 2007 seats as a complete set to someone who just wants to drop them right into their car, like someone who has a base model Rabbit or a Golf with a 2.5 in it that they just want to upgrade the seats, or if someone has leather and they want to put plaid in. So that is, I think that's the direction we're going to go with the seats. So we do have a lot more stuff to wrap up inside the car as far as just finishing up these seat bases. Even though I have seats bolted to them, I still need to go and there's like little pieces that I need to make to cap off the ends, just solidify everything to make it look complete. I could certainly drive around town if I had everything else done. I could drive around town with the seats the way they are, but I think that finishing it off and making it you know, all the ends covered and all the little gaps. There's still going to be some gaps where the floor pan has a little valley for the strengthening ribs. I didn't cut out the metal to fit those. I probably should have if I was going to go for a super pro finish, but having a few gaps in here and there will allow us to get inside with some rust proofing, which is a bonus. And that's something we're going to cover once I have all of the seat mounting rails done and welded up. We're going to go through and I've got some product from Eastwood. Again, something I've had in a box for a couple of years, waiting for this thing to get to this point. But we'll go through and we'll rust proof the triangle that goes across in front of the footwell. We'll do the insides of the rockers and we'll do the insides of the seat mounting points that we've built before we put down a coating on the inside of the car here. So one thing that I did want to show you guys is, let me run around to the driver's side here. Don't ever try to tell yourself that blue tape is an acceptable substitute for putting anything in the right way. But I am sitting here in the driver's seat with a horrible glare. I'm gonna see if I can get this GoPro to slide it out a little mount here. So I am holding the GoPro right on my center mass there, and you can see the steering wheel's right in front of us. My foot's lined up with the accelerator pedal. Clutch pedal feels good. I mean, taking the time to do all of our painful, laborious post, or I should say really sleepy math, paid off, and we were able to get the seat exactly where I wanted it, positioned in the car so that I'm not reaching side to side for the steering wheel or the pedals. No, it feels good. I haven't been behind the steering wheel of a Rabbit for, oh man, it's probably been 6 or 7 years since I've gotten to drive one of these cars. So it feels really nice to be back. You know, it's comfortable territory to be behind the seat of one of these cars again, or behind the wheel, even though it's far from done. I'm going to keep this episode today short. I know that sometimes it's hard to sit down and watch a whole half hour. But I'm going to pull these seats out, pull the door panels back off, which is just held on by blue tape. It'll come off real easy. And put some stuff back in storage, you know, try to keep it from getting damaged until we go to use this stuff. And you won't see these seats again for quite some time because they're going to go back up on the shelf out of the way. And so that we can do all the things that we need to do inside the car. We already know the seats are going to fit. One of the next projects that's going to be coming up, besides finishing up the floor pan, is going to be the back seat. I'm not an auto body or upholstery guy, but I am going to try to do the seat myself. It's a flat seat. It's real easy to work with. So I am going to try to show you guys at least how to get the seat taken apart. I'm going to learn some stuff on upholstery. I have access to an industrial sewing machine. So I'm going to learn how to sew. And we're going to work on making a back seat that matches this driver's seat. So next time on Jalopy Shop, we are going to we're going to take the back seat out of the car here, and
we are going to strip it down, which you'll be amazed if you haven't done it, how quick a seat comes apart. And then we're also going to take the back seat that came at, you know, the 2015 back seat, which is in three pieces, and we're going to take that apart so that we can just store the fabric, not the whole seat. And then we will start working on a plan to make, we're going to have to order some fabric, something that kind of matches the outsides of these seats. We might be able to use some of the stuff we already have, but we'll see. So that's our plan. Next time, I hope to be working on taking apart the back seat. I know I'm kind of doing it in a weird way, like doing the upholstery first and putting the seats in first, but these were like the two biggest projects that I'm the least confident about. So like, I know I can take that engine out of there, I know I can put it up on the bench and we can tear it down and go through it and put it all back together and it'll be fine. I'm pretty confident that I can do the rocker panel here on the driver's side that looks like a penguin pooped on it on a cold day. My welding was pretty bad. So we're going to dig into the hardest stuff first and get that out of the way. And when I'm done with the seats, I can put them back up on top of the cabinets in the corner of the garage. And I won't have to worry about them until I'm ready to actually put them in the car and drive it. So, but getting these two big headache projects out of the way and really making a steep learning curve for what I got going on here, that was the goal of this whole, building this YouTube channel and showing you guys how I'm doing stuff, is educating myself, making myself better at doing all this, learning some new stuff. And when I get to the stuff that I'm more familiar with, I have this in my tool belt already. I know for some of you, you may not see the correlation between making a bracket for a seat and building intercooler tubing, but every time you practice measuring and putting stuff together and working on those tolerances in your welding, you get better at it every time. So that's my plan, is do the hard stuff first. We've still got a lot of little things to finish up inside the car here, and we'll be showing you guys that along the way too. So thanks for watching
Throttle Grotto.
If you like what you're doing or what we're doing here, subscribe to the channel. We got a lot more stuff to do on this car. If you haven't watched the bonus episode, we really talk in a little more detail about all of the things that we need to do to get this car on the road. And it's a big list. You know, this car hasn't been on the road in, oh gosh, it's been 8 years now, I think, since this car last ran under its own power. So a lot of stuff to do. Thanks for watching. And now it's your turn to get out there and work on something.